Hello everyone. Welcome to the 18th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I will teach you how to use track mat and place the video inside the text and shape. I already created a composition, and now I drag this video on the timeline. You can see track mat option in this section. If you can't find the option here, click this icon. To put this video inside a text, I create a text. I make the text a little bigger and place it in the center of the composition panel. To place the anchor point in the center of the text, I hold down the control button and double-click on the pan behind tool. Now in front of the video layer, instead of the none option, I choose the film option. Film is the name of the text layer that I typed. In this way, we see a part of the video inside the text, and the other parts of the video disappear. Also, instead of selecting the layer name, you can use the whip tool to select the desired layer. To do this, hold the left click on the whip tool and drag on the desired layer. By enabling track mat for each layer, the visibility of that layer will be turned off. Now I import another video and put it in the timeline. At the bottom of the letter T, which stands for the word transparency, by clicking on each square, we can activate or deactivate the transparency of the layer we placed as background. To highlight the edges of the text, I right-click on the video layer and select Bevel and Emboss from the Layer Style option. I go into the Bevel and Emboss settings and increase the Size option. You can see the changes made to the text. I close the settings of this layer. Now I want to create an animation using track mat. Therefore, I select the text layer and use the pan behind tool to place the anchor point in the desired location. Now, after selecting the layer, I press the letter S to reveal the text scale option. I create two keyframes at frame 0 and second 4. Now I go back to frame 0 and increase the scale value. I select both keyframes and right-click on one of them, and select the Easy Ease option to make the movement smoother. Now I will press the play button to see the animation together. I remove both keyframes and return the text scale to the previous state. This time, if I click on the empty square on the right side, mat will be reversed, and now we can see the following video inside the text. I activate Luma mat by clicking on the square on the left. To understand this better, I will delete the text layer and create a rectangle. I increase the rectangle stroke. This time I use the whip tool to select the layer as matte. In this way, we can see a part of the video below inside the rectangle. Now I activate Luma matte. You can see that the fill and stroke transparency values of the video are different inside the shape. Now, if I change the fill color to white, the video inside the rectangle becomes clearer. And if I move to black, the video slowly disappears. Now we can only see the part of the video inside the stroke. I press the play button. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.